TV Delaware is brought to you by Black Bear Archery, St. George's, Delaware, the first state's first choice for sales, service, expert advice on all kinds of archery-related supplies and bows. Also brought to you by Mark's Butcher Shop. You gut him, he cuts him. Mark's Butcher Shop is located off Grantham Lane in Newcastle, Delaware. Visit Mark's Butcher Shop for expert butchering. And DS Design. DS Designs for all kinds of graphics.
Yeah. Mark's Butcher Shop, Newcastle, Delaware. Time to process a deer from the skinning room, ready to process it. When we get it here, it should be pretty clean, ready to go. Just to stake it out, roast it out, grind it, pack it, ready to go, call the customer, come get it. If they want to get it fresh, they get it fresh. If not, if a couple of days, we'll freeze it, but I prefer you getting it fresh. I don't really want to store them too long. So the hind quarter, the three main muscles you have here, I explained before, I take them out one at a time and then clean them up a little bit. And this is what I'm taking off is all meat, just for hamburger. For grind. Alright, this is the just an inside round or the top round. As far as beef names go, that's that muscle. All the muscle groups are pretty much the same in all these animals. So that's the top round. And that's about how I like to do it. Now I can stake that out or put chips in it. It shouldn't meet down the bottom, comes out. Take off any heavy gristle or fat that I don't think is desirable. And that rest goes into the grind pile. Always looking for hairs. This is the last stage. You gotta see all the hairs here. And separate this knuckle from the bottom round. This piece is called a bottom round in beef. It's actually called the whole bottom or gooseneck, which has the bottom round flat and then the eye roast. Here's an eye roast right here. It's a miniature eye roast. In a beef or a cow, they're about 8 pounds. In a deer, they're not even a pound. I'll take off the fat. I'll take off the silver on the side. And the fat goes into the chicken. And that we can grind. And that's waste. Flip it over. Give it more of this fat. I don't leave this in. A lot of butchers leave this stuff in. And that's why you get that gamey flavor. But that's when you get extra meat, but it's not really extra meat to me. If you leave it in there to make it look like it's more, and if they don't like it, then what's the point? I do them like I do them for myself. For years I did them on a saw. for people like I was taught when I was a kid. And then at the end of the day, when I was done doing all my customers' deer, I would pull my deer out and do it like this. And for like 2 years I was doing this, and I said to myself one day, why am I doing this for people on a saw, and then my deer, I'm cutting like this, because this is the way to do it. I wouldn't even need a deer to cut on a saw, because the muscles are cut wrong, it's just not good product. So I got rid of my saw, and decided that day that I'm going to do it like this for everybody. And it took a while for people to get used to it. They wanted the bones, they wanted this and that, but here it is 10 years later, and I don't hear any complaints. That muscle is ready to go. It's the last muscle here. This is the third best muscle. There's the hip and the knuckle. I take this hip right here, there's the hip or the sirloin, they call it in beef. That's burger. That's a nice muscle for roast. Actually, on a bigger deer like this, you could get a couple steaks out of it. So they'd be good and tender. When a cutty would cut like this against the grain. But I usually save this for roast. That's a great piece for a roast. Then there's this knuckle here. Take off these little ears. They wrap around the bone. On both sides. More fat off the top. And that's the back leg. So these three muscles are ready to go for whatever direction. And if you look at the green sheet that the customer filled out, it'll tell us how they want their deer. This guy would say steaks, so he would get steaks out of this. So what I would do is I would cut these down in against the grain. See, that's the beauty of growing them out. You can cut them against the grain. When they're all in the leg in one big piece with the bone, you're cutting cross grain. You're not getting the most tender cut out of it. Here's your steaks. The inside round. Here's your bottom round.
Show
a piece
of steak, like pull one out and show
it. That's your center piece of the top round. Here's your bottom round steak, which has the eye connected to it. And this is your knuckle steak. They call these knuckles or sirloin tip steaks. Some people call this a football roast. I don't know why. It looks like a football, I guess. That's your sirloin steak. So those three muscles are done, and that's your steaks. We pack them up 3 or 4 in a pack and vacuum seal them so they're ready to go for you. You can marinate them, put them on the grill, cut them up in little pieces, make stew out of it. A lot of options there. Back strap, we just clean these up a little bit. I take a little piece off the end, that's the shoulder end piece, and that goes with the hip for the roast. I try to get the silver off without losing too much meat. The silver you don't want to leave on it. That you'll never be able to, you don't cook down, you'll chew forever. You have to take that off. So we'll take that off. They even save a little meat. That's just how I am. I cut it in 2 or 3 pieces. Pack that separately and we mark it back strap so they know what it is. Tenderloins, already cleaned up back there, so they're good to go. We'll wrap them separately and mark them. And shoulder, we'll do the good one this time. Those are your steaks. Okay, and we got the neck meat right here. Which is, a lot of guys want to roast out of it, but it's a tough roast. But to cook a little extra longer to get it to tender up. So I just throw it into the grind. Unless, of course, the shoulder is tore up too much where we can't get enough meat for roast. Then you can use the neck, but I don't use it perfectly. That big chunk of fat is always in the shoulder. We take that out. Okay. Comes up. Okay, this is all burger meat right here. All this stuff that hangs around the shoulder. As you can see, the shoulder is not even attached to the deer. There's no joint or socket that attaches the shoulder to the deer. It just actually floats. Pretty amazing how strong they are and how fast they can run, and the shoulder isn't even attached. It just floats in that area, held by cartilage. Pretty amazing. You know that, Art? Pretty wild, huh? Yeah, I like to start here just bone that's below the shin and grab this big hunk of meat as part of this lower shoulder. So that's a good piece for roast. So I can try to get that off with the one piece. Just seam it right there. Find that joint. Comes right apart. Just like that. So anything left on this shin now is burger meat. So I take a minute, take that meat off of there. Tough, but it does grind up. It doesn't hurt the burger to have some of this grainy stuff in it. As long as you don't have any big hunks of white fat, that's where you get that wild flavor. So, put the rest of the time into that. Looks good. Alright, and the shoulder blade is a unique muscle. It's kind of a weird shape. So the bottom side's flat, so start there first. I take the meat off of the bottom part of the shoulder belly. Right there, blade is flat right on the bottom. This is where the inside that goes connects to the deer. This floats against the rib cage. This bone right here. How, I don't know. Flip it over. And there's two nice little muscles on the shoulder that are good for roast. One side is like a called a Saratoga. And beef, this is a nice little muscle that goes in the roast. And run the bone down the other side of that muscle, butt bone. It's called a shoulder butt, just the butt of the deer. Ironically, it's in the shoulder, but it's called a butt. Clean this up a little bit, take some fat off of it, and that's good for roast. This pile will be seasoned up and jet netted, and that's great roast for a crock pot. 6 hours in there with some veggies and carrots, corn, onions, and all the muscles there. So you saw the muscles. That's what the other side, the same thing, just the opposite side. So you're the same result. And after that, we pack it, wrap it, call you up, come and get it. And that's pretty much it. If you want to try it at home, give it a shot. This is Mark Butcher Shop signing off, Newcastle. Hope to see you soon. Keep calling them.
Urban Hunter TV Delaware is brought to you by Black Bear Archery, St. George's, Delaware. The first state's first choice for sales, service, expert advice on all kinds of archery-related supplies and bows. Also brought to you by Mark's Butcher Shop. You gut them, he cuts them. Mark's Butcher Shop is located off Grantham Lane in Newcastle, Delaware. Visit Mark's Butcher Shop for expert butchering. And DS Designs. DS Designs for all kinds of graphics.